never existed. The war between the sadistic and the realistic had been predicted. Yeah. The balance of the world's power shifted when artistic control was given to the wicked and lifted from the gifted. When I was born, a female mystic insisted she enter the room, leaned over my forehead and kissed it. Inside me, my assignments were listed. I was never told this till I was older, fearing the risk that I resisted. The first composition I ever composed triggered a conscious thought probe that the mystic had enclosed. I folded in an agonizing pose. When it was over, I would hold the keys to expose the motives of the soul. Meanwhile, on the same side of the globe, a slow-growing entity drove the masses to ignorance overload. I stayed inside my reclusive mode, and although this was strange, I still didn't complain, though I blatantly noticed the change. I started having recollections, nostalgic reflections of things that ignited mental resurrection. Now every audio-visual object we digest contributes to this gradual degenerative process. Nonetheless, I wasn't under stress. I just rested and convalesced, sharpened my talents to soar beyond the best. Fell asleep, it felt like something was being put on my head. I woke up and saw two individuals at the foot of my bed. One said,
"Listen, Carino, you've been chosen to fight the deadly force that germinated and rose in the night. All the knowledge that you'll need I'll expose on this flight.
What's up with this paralysis?
You're frozen in light.
Well, can you unfreeze me? And please be quick about telling me the reason why you come to seize me," he said.
"I'm sure you've heard of the machine where we've convened concerning its destruction, and we've chosen you to lead the team. Folks are going to die. You have no choice, so you better comply,"
I said. "I was no one special, I'm just a regular guy," he said.
"That's a lie. You were born for this, never deny."
I looked in his eyes and said, "Okay, man, whatever, I'll try." 2 seconds later, I went from my room to on the craft, inside the lab where I received training to run the staff. What seemed like one day of training had been a year. The mystic reappeared and said, "No one must interfere." I said, "Lady, I could be wrong, but I feel like I know you." She smiled and said, "You do, and at the proper time, I'll show you. As for the masses, there's a fate you have to save them from. Look at the people and how disillusioned they become. The thought streams that this machine is filtering are ill-meaning and bewildering. You have to kill this thing. You'll have to start with all of its compartments and execute mark hits on targets from Earth or orbit." After I listened, I started on my mission with one magician from the spacecraft as my assistant. The first place he brung me, it stunned me. What I saw living among me, 85% were already zombies. The schools and the streets and the houses were doused with the venom of lying governments and sick media outlets. All intelligent thoughts that sprout get rerouted and ousted. I had to obliterate the whole outfit, but where was it stationed? We tried to pinpoint its location with extrasensory perceptive navigation. 2 seconds after springing to action, I saw on the caption the giant shadow of a robotic contraption. I turned around and shockingly seen a technologically supreme object that no logic could possibly dream. Everything that it said was obscene, plus its head was a screen. It blasted at me with a red glowing beam. I blasted back with a shot of my own medulla oblongata, lava fire straight out of my bottomless dome. I heard a voice that made my hair raise. To paraphrase, it said,
"We'll forever convey our wicked ways over the airwaves. Can't stop the rise, we were put here to deceive the wise. We're the ones who say the truth and make people believe the lies. Made the world slave, so don't defy it.
To save it, I would try it. It was modern day David and Goliath. This denial den that we resided in was multiplying. This Leviathan was like trying to escape the Poseidon. So every great phrase that was ever spoken, I quoted, decoded, and overloaded its modem till it exploded. When it blew up, I was glad and released it. Till I seen new machines forming from each of the fragmented pieces. Now I gotta overcome the offspring, the children of them. I went from dealing with just one to a million of them. A whole army in the distance ahead. And prisoners of listeners tapped my assistant and said, I need a G719 skill gun. He said, I never heard of that. I said, I know, I just made it up. Go build one. He left and said, okay, I go get it. Just hold him off for a minute. 60 seconds later, he reappeared with it. I snatched it with no time to study or test it. It consisted of just one definite button, so I pressed it. Man, I awoke in a cloud of smoke. I saw people, one of them stepped out of the crowd and spoke. "It's so enlightening to be mentally redeemed," he said. I'm like, "What happened?" He said, "Look, all the machines are dead. Conscious thinking at the ultimate degree again. No more government commercial radio or CNN. The gas released out of your weapon made the cameras fall. Reversed the spell of the machine and deprogrammed us all." I said, "But there were millions, how could we persist to live?
After the wisdom, everyone took the initiative.
One by one, they were individually destroyed by everything with knowledge, all functions deployed. They sparked a process with cerebral brainwashing, narcotics, scientific control, anatomic robotics, melodic hypnotics. The mystic being delivered my fate, way that erased my memory, sending me back to my original state. You wonder.